Hi there, I'm Mick Brambles. You know, television is changing. And the way we watch television is also changing. What with the advent of platforms such as Netflix, torrents, catch-up TV, we ask what does the future hold for television? And how do young people's viewing habits, how will that affect our beloved pastime? Mick Brambles. Mick Brambles. The final most poignant question we're going to ask today is just to what extent can television really control the masses? And in essence, are we all sheep? In order to find the answers to some of our very important questions, we need to go to somewhere where there's a large amount of young people living there. Now, with a population of roughly 120,867, of which 24,000 are students, we're going to go somewhere where the beer flows like wine and where people mess around on planks of wood with big sticks. That's right, we're heading to the picturesque city of Cambridge. Mick Brambles. Cambridge. Yes, we're here in this picture postcard city. Beautiful universities and people with bicycles. And we want to get to the bottom of young people's viewing habits.
Is either dramas or comedies. For example, I've seen Breaking Bad in a row. I'm following up with Game of Thrones.
Generally speaking, whatever's on, my viewing habits are erratic.
Mostly American TV series, like Pretty Little Liars, Vampire Diaries, all of that sort of stuff.
Things like Family Guy and Russell Howard's Good News and all those kind of things. And I like the small comedies on BBC Three and things like that.
Lots of reality TV, embarrassingly, Big Brother, X Factor, The Voice.
Usually on my own, I mean, if someone's over, we'll watch a movie.
I watch TV alone.
Generally, I watch TV with other people.
Mainly alone while I'm here, but back home, I usually watch with family, mainly.
I tend to watch it with other people.
Stream it from the internet, watch it on my laptop.
Online.
I prefer to watch things online, personally, because you've got more control over what it is you're watching, because 9 times out of 10, the stuff they put on television is rubbish.
But generally through an aerial.
Yeah, teens now use way more internet to watch TV because TV stations now don't have the updated seasons, while everyone on the internet now can have everything really quick and easy.
I think someone's going to attach a camera to the moon and have like a world Big Brother.
I think kind of TV and computer and all these kind of things are going to start merging, so I think you'll have internet on your TV.
I think they'll be projected from sunglasses or something equivalent to.
Completely online, unless more movies become available via the television.
The TV controls a lot of people in a lot of ways.
Definitely, yeah.
I think television definitely has the ability to create an image that it's like, you need to be like this, you need to be like that, like it. Put certain people on a pedestal and makes them out to be like better than everyone else, and it's like you should be like this and not be like this person.
You've got TOWIE, and that just tells people how they should be living because it's on a TV screen, it's everywhere.
Even if you're not watching it, you're subconsciously listening and you are influenced by the TV.
No, I do not like EastEnders.
EastEnders, never heard of that.
I don't personally watch it, I used to. I think it can become a bit depressing.
Hate it. I absolutely hate it.
Can't stand it.
Why don't I like it?
Yeah.
Because I don't, it's EastEnders.
Oh. So there we have it. Young people seem to be watching less and less terrestrial television than ever before. And if they're going to change, and they're going to continue with those habits, then the broadcasters need to change with them. Or lose out. No, come back. Come on. No, come on. Guys, don't leave me here again. No. Guys, don't forget about Mick. Guys, I'm Mick Brambles, damn it.
Place. I went home and took a shot when I left.